What's up, guys? Today we're going to learn the song that John Mayer just released about 45 minutes ago. Stayed up till midnight to listen to the song, and we're staying up till about 4 a.m. to do this tutorial for you guys. So hope you enjoy it. Just hit that thumbs up button to show us some support. Let's get into it. We got three different parts we're going to learn today. We've got the main chord progression, then the pre-chorus and chorus progression, and then I'll show you a little bit of the solo. Big shout out to Guitar Pro for sponsoring this video. They're how I've made all my tabs and music for years, and they've got a great program that I use every day. And they've just released a new app that you can follow along with songs with the video playing, along with tabs that sync up to the actual app itself, so you can learn songs while following along with the tabs. Super useful. Check it out on the link in the description below. Now let's get into the video. All right, let's go into it with the first chord progression. This part is played for the verses, super simple. Chords we've got here are D, E minor 7, A, B minor, and G. So we're gonna go D to E minor 7 twice. And then you're gonna go B minor, A, G. That's all there is to it. And you're just going to do one simple strum for each of the chords, and you're going to repeat this section for both of the verses. Now the second part is when we play the pre-chorus and the chorus, and that comes in when he says we're searching for the night together. And our chords are mostly the same, just a little change up. We're going to go from a G to a D to an A to a B minor. Four chords, we've already seen all four of them, and it's going to sound like this. That part's going to be played for the choruses and the pre-choruses. Now in the second pre-chorus and chorus, if you want to liven things up a bit, if you're playing on your own, it might be more interesting if you add a little strumming pattern in there. And it doesn't have to be anything specific, just something interesting and pretty nice to play, just to give it a little bit more energy in the second pre-chorus, especially if you don't have a full band behind you. So what I was doing there was, even slower. And that's all the chord parts. So that's the verses, the pre-chorus, and the chorus with those two different parts. Then we've got this little solo thing that also goes under his vocals at some point. And that part sounds like this. It's pretty simple to play. So try it out. We're going to throw in a little bit of distortion. You can play this all on an acoustic guitar if you want to, if that's what you have. No problems. It'll work just the same. So you can see it's a pretty smooth, simple solo right there. Doesn't take too much. I just learned this by ear about 6 minutes ago, and I'll show you how to play it quickly. It helps if you throw on a little bit of distortion, but if you don't have that, you don't need to. So we're going to start on the 7th fret, and we're going to slide up to the 10th. Then you go 7th to 12th. And it helps to add a little bit of vibrato at these end notes, which is just shaking your string a little. Then you're gonna go 4, 7, 7 on the third and the last notes on the second string. And then take that 7th fret and slide down to the 5th. So that's that whole first section. Then moving on to the second half of it, we're going to repeat those first two slides. Then this time we're going to go up to the 15th fret and slide down to the 12th. Always keep that vibrato in, and then go to the 10th fret and slide down to the 5th. And then we've got this little riff at the end. Which is really simple to finish it off. On the 4th string, 7th fret, hammer on to 9th. Then 7th on the 3rd string. And back up to that 7th fret. And then 9th fret on 3rd down to 4th. So that's... And then you're going to slide on that 4th string from the 7th to 9th fret. So that whole little segment. And right there's the entire solo. You can throw in a ton of vibrato everywhere. It's smooth and gentle and clean. And you just practice it for a little bit, get a little smoother than I did because I just learned this and I'm teaching it on the fly. But that's what it is, all together. That's all there is to it. So there's the verse, the pre-chorus and chorus, and the solo. With those three parts, you can play this entire song. Hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, make sure to hit that thumbs up button. Let me know what you thought of this song and the video in the comments below. Make sure to subscribe if you haven't already, and I'll see you in the next video.